So when did you open this location?
This location we opened almost 7 years ago. Yeah. And I'll tell you, I had always, since I've been out in Los Angeles, I've been in LA for 25 years. I've always run my business out of pre-existing gyms. So I'll go into a giant powerhouse or a giant Gold's gym, and I'll rent a suite of offices, and I will train my clients out of those places. They will pay a membership fee to the gym, plus they will pay my training fee. Yeah. And if there are pieces of equipment that I need to use for my clients that are not at those gyms, at my own expense, I would buy that equipment, and everyone can use it as long as I can use it also with my clients. And it always worked out. And then about 7 years ago, something really crazy happened. And that is, across the board in a uniform way, the quality of the experience of the average gym goer in Los Angeles started to sink, meaning the gyms started cutting the hours of the cleaning crew. So the gyms were a little dirtier than they had been previously. The gym started not leaving the air conditioning on hot days. So it was a little stuffier than normal. The gym started getting a little grumpy, where if someone wanted to come in for a workout with me for the first time, they would charge them some fee when I had an agreement with them that, hey, someone that comes in the first time, the gym's rule is you can work out one time for free before you join.
Yeah.
And yet there to see me, they would make them pay a fee. Like, there suddenly became a double standard.
Yeah.
And I started to become annoyed. It takes a lot to make me annoyed, but I started getting annoyed. And then the straw that broke the camel's back occurred. And that was, I got a call from Paramount. I'm hired mostly by the studios, Universal, Paramount, Warner Brothers. I got a call from Paramount. They said, look, we have a woman who's going to be in the new Tom Cruise movie. We'd love for you to work with her. We're sending her over right now in a limousine. She'll be at your gym in 5 minutes. And I was like, awesome. I can't wait to meet her. So I was in my office waiting for this actress to arrive. She pulls up at the gym, gets out, goes into the gym, and goes up to the $10 an hour front desk guy who's working his way through college and just got hired there last week. And she said, I'm here to see Eric the trainer. And the guy looks up to her and he says, do you have a membership here? And she said, no. And he goes, well, then you can't come in. She starts to cry, gets back in the limousine, goes back to Paramount. I get a call from Paramount and they said, well, you just lost that client because she was refused entry to your gym. That was the straw that broke the camel's back. So I went and met with the owners. I said, you know what? I've decided to move on. I wish you the very best of luck. And all the equipment that I've purchased for this place, you can keep. I don't want it. You can keep it as a sign of goodwill. I gathered my clients and we opened this place up. And when I left, I had so many clients at that gym. It was a powerhouse gym. It went out of business.
Yeah.
That's how, dude, we have about 400 people we train out of this location.
That many? How many square feet do you have there?
I don't know, man. I mean, I can take you on a little tour.
Before the end, I was going to ask you that. Before the end, grab your phone and we'll do a little tour before the end.
I mean, did you see Willy Wonka? This place is kind of like Willy Wonka's chocolate factory. It's insane. Like, yeah. It boggles my mind that it exists. It's like seeing a two-headed horse. Like, you're like, I see it, but my brain is not processing correctly. Like, dude, this is heaven. This gym is like the manifestation of anything I would ever want in a fitness facility. That it's like a dream come true. I mean, I'm the luckiest kid from Maine you've ever met.
What's the guitar behind you? You play guitar? Or is that a present by somebody?
Oh, no. We train a lot of musicians that you know, including Def Leppard, Journey, Nickelback, The Strokes, Fall Out Boy. Some of them were here this morning. And so we keep several guitars in the office because I'll be training one of these guys, like Phil Collin from Def Leppard, who plays thousands of people with his shirt off every single day. And he's 64 years old.
Yeah.
And like, wait a minute. And he'll run in the office and he'll start playing. He's like, that's it. And so these are sort of like,
I love it.
But yeah, dude.